Good morning, students. Welcome back. In our previous video, we have discussed meaning of personality and its definition. So today, let's start with approaches to study of personality. Psychologists interested in the study of personality and try to answer some or certain questions about the nature and origin of individual differences in personality. You may have observed that two children in the same family develop dramatically different personalities. Not only they look physically different, but they also behave differently in different situations. This observation often generates curiosity and forces us to ask, why is it that some people react differently in a given situation? Why is it that some people enjoy adventurous activities while others like reading, watching television or playing cards? Are these differences stable all through one's life, or are they just short-lived and situation-specific? So, a number of approaches and theories have been developed to understand and explain behavioral differences among individuals and behavioral consequences within an individual. So these theories or approaches are based on different models of human behavior. So let's start with types of personality. Psychologists distinguish between type and trait approaches to personality. Recently, psychologists have attempted to study personality in their own way. They have formulated various theories to explain personality. These are divided into two types. First is type theories, second is type trait theories. We can say approaches also. Both these theories or approaches of personality focus on people's personal characteristics. However, type theorists and trait theorists differ in the way they use characteristics to describe people. Here is, firstly, types theories of personality. Efforts to categorize people into personality types have been made since ancient times. The Greek physician Hippocrates had proposed a typology of personality based on fluid or humor. Here, firstly, I will explain meaning of typology. So, typology meaning ways of categorizing individuals into discrete categories or types. For example, type A personality, type B personality, that is typology, categorizing individuals into categories. In India, also Charak Sanhita, famous treatise on Ayurveda, classified people into categories of Vata, Pitta and Kapha on the basis of three humor elements called Tridosha. Here, Hippocrates categorized people on the basis of body elements such as Pitta, Vata, Kapha and prominent personality characteristics associated with them such as, firstly I will clear Pitta, Vata and Kapha meaning. I will start with Vata. Vata is the energy of movement. Pitta is the energy of digestion or metabolism. And Kapha is the energy of lubrication and structure. So in physical body, Vata is a subtle energy of movement. Pitta is the energy of digestion and metabolism. And Kapha, the energy of that forms the body's structure. This is the meaning of all this. Here you can see all the characteristics of personality here in this diagram. Then you can understand all these characteristics. So for today, that's it. Next time we will discuss and start with type theories. Thank you.